Hey guys, before the video starts today, I just want to quickly shout out my boy Ronin, ML Goody, Jagex Ronin, Mod Ronin, whatever you guys want to call him. He actually started uploading videos again on his channel. If you guys don't know him, please watch him. He's an absolutely amazing creator. I'm going to leave a link to the video uploaded in the description of this video, so go check it out and welcome him back to the YouTube game. What is up, guys? Today is Thursday, which means it is Update Thursday on Old School RuneScape, and today we have a special one, I guess, because we have a lot of new items coming into the game, just not permanently. They're coming in to the tournament worlds, and that is all the rewards of the Theater of Blood, which is going to be the Raids 2 that is coming out later this year. We also have some quality of life updates this month and some more information on the upcoming demo mode tournament, so I'm going to be going over those first and then testing out the new raids item at the end of the video. The upcoming demo mode spring finals are going to be happening at 12 p.m. GMT on Friday, March 9th, so tomorrow is when the next demo mode tournament starts, and they're going to run until the following Saturday, the 17th, culminating in the permadeath stage. We'll be live from 7 p.m. GMT on the Saturday on twitch.tv/oldschoolrs, so they're going to be streaming it as usual, so make sure you guys tune in to see who takes home the $20,000 grand prize. There are some changes this season to the demo mode tournament, so make sure to check out the dev blog that I will link in the description of this video. And they also changed sort of how the layout looks for the stream, so when we see the fights at the very end, you can see HP and all this other great stuff. So and the players' inventories too, which actually looks really good. So if demo mode interests you and you're going to be playing, make sure to check out this part of the update today. I unfortunately, for the first time ever, won't be doing the demo mode tournament. I just didn't feel like playing this time. Unfortunately, I just want to do some other things, but I'll definitely be looking forward to watching everybody play it, and the finals are going to be great as usual. Next up, we have this month's quality of life updates, and I have to say that that second one there looks very, very good to me, but we'll get to it when the time comes. First off, we have the spinning wheel interface has been updated to use the new make all interface. Second off, we have that Tears of Guthix streams will now last a minimum of 9 seconds before moving. And no, this does not mean streams on Twitch. This means streams on the Tears of Guthix minigame, which, again, for those of you guys who have ever done Tears of Guthix on RuneScape, you'll remember that these streams that happen there, the blue streams that you need to collect is with the tears, they move frequently. They move very, very constantly, which is very, very annoying, because sometimes you'll be trying to get the tears and they'll move away and you keep moving. So it's very, very annoying. So the amount of points you get was very, very random. But now the fact that they last 9 seconds before moving means I wonder what the average amount of points is going to be. It has to go up like crazy. I remember getting, I think on a Questscape account, which is an account you can stay there the longest on, I probably get like 140 points average per one. I wonder, I mean, I'm going to show you guys the results right now on this video. Again, I pre-record this and then record the footage after. So whatever you guys see right now is going to be my final tier count. So I'm guessing it's going to be quite a bit more, because the fact that you can stay at a stream for 9 seconds now minimum is pretty crazy. Interesting one right there. I mean, I'm going to be getting 99 runecrafting on my account in no time, so it's going to be great. Players may now store buckets, compost, super compost, ultra compost, and plant cure with leprechauns with noted versions of the items. Again, that's actually very, very nice as well. The amount of XP you receive when splashing with the entangle swell has been slightly reduced, so you know when the bind has been applied. The dark core pet no longer has sounds attached to its animations. And finally, another orb has been added beside the minimap to display your current special attack energy. The orb is display only and cannot be clicked to use the special attack. So that one's, I guess, a bit controversial, I have to say. Some people don't like it. I mean, I know you can use it with the West Buddy, but the fact it's on the main client there, what do you guys think about that? In the another news this week, we have quite a few changes, but nothing really out of the ordinary. God Sword shards have been repositioned in the inventory to fix graphical issues. Disabling the wilderness teleport now works via the Gorak teleport. Left clicking a furnace while carrying steel bars and no ore is now interpreted as a request to make cannonballs, similarly to how it already works for crafting gold and silver jewelry. Various supplies inside Bar Basalt can now be destroyed by shift-clicking them. The Enchant Crossbow Bolt now requires the correct magic level of 49 to cast. And for those of you guys who play demo mode, there is now a delay before being able to travel via the Lovakenge cart system. This one's actually worth mentioning as well. The old school team has decided that they're going to stop using bit.ly links, so bit.ly links, because they sort of associate it with phishing. A lot of fishers enjoy using these bit.ly links because they sort of hide that the website itself is a phishing site or a scamming site. So they're actually going to be using the osrs.game links in the future. So that's actually very nice of them that they decided to finally change that. So anytime you see a link from the old school team, it's going to be in this form and not any other form. So again, please don't get fished. Though I know one of you is, and you know who you are. Now let's head to the new tournament worlds and check out these new raids armors. Now the first thing I see when I log in is this guy saying, the new rapier is gonna rune PKing. Ah, ha ha ha. I can't tell if this is just a really good pun or if he's just terrible at spelling. But as you can see, all this pink armor is all the new rewards that are being pulled. They actually haven't really detailed them yet and added color to them. They always do this with new, I guess, beta testing items. They just make it pink so people know it's not really an official item yet. So we're going to take from the tournament supplies, and all the way down here, we can see we have these lovely new items. So we have the Infernal Defender, the Sanguinesti Staff, Vampirium Vambrace's that face guard, it's in the Torag's form, the chest guard, the leg guard, the rapier, and the Sith of Viter. So we have these 8 items to look forward to potentially coming into the game. It's important to remember that these are just placeholder versions of what's actually going to be coming into the game. Again, I know you guys probably thinking these look exactly like Torags and the Defenders and, you know, the Vambraces. They look terrible. It's just the Scythe and the Staff. It's just Staff of the Dead. Again, these are just placeholder items. They are not going to be the final released version. They are just putting them in the game right now so we can test them out, especially because these are mainly just focusing on these stats instead of how the armors actually look themselves. In the update, they say that they are actually going to be releasing these tournament worlds again, which I'm in right now. You're going to find out you're able to try the rewards anywhere you'd like rather than recent tournament worlds offering, which were limited to PvP. Please note that you can only access the proposed weapons and armors. The proposed prayer and potions do not yet exist and cannot be accessed. If you guys saw earlier, the chests actually contain ecumenical keys, which will allow you to skip the God Wars kill count requirements. Players are able to get unlimited Slayer tasks in these worlds. Slayer Masters will offer a new task even if you have a task assigned. A multitude of teleports have been added to the chest to allow ease of transport to various encounters. So if you guys want to test this out for yourself, test maybe some God Wars dungeon bosses, make sure to log into the tournament worlds. I will have a video out testing these armors probably this weekend. In this video, I'm mainly going to try it out, and I guess in the portals and maybe some other areas as well, but mainly just the portals, just to see what the attack animations look like and see, you know, what kind of stats they give. Again, I do apologize if I am doing things incorrectly in terms of setups. I'm not really great with this sort of thing, but if you guys, again, want to test it out for yourself, then feel free to log into the tournament worlds. But the first thing I'm going to do is just straight up test out the rapier, the 3 different armors, and then the Infernal Defender as well. We just straight up have a melee build here, Barrow's Gloves, Prim Boots, Zerker Ring, Infernal Cape, and the Amulet of Torture. So again, I think a lot of people are testing this out as well. Let's just go ahead pot up and see if we can get a fight. Here are what the stats look like, by the way. If you guys want to pause the video and just look at them in depth, you can. We have 137 melee strength, and our stab defense is 360, and stab bonus is 150, which I think most people are going to be using the new rapier anyway, so that's what our bonuses are. I'm not really going to try to go for a KO. I just want to see some of the hits that I can get from this. All right, come here, Aaron. So he's wearing Bandos, Serapelm, Prim Boots, Infernal Cape. Let's see if we can get any hits on him. Again, you don't really see this in PvP. Nobody's going to be doing this, but so far it's just a bunch of zero. I think I have XP drops turned off. There we go. There's a 42. That's the first one. I'm just going to make this a stake. There we go. Okay, so we won the stake. Let's go, baby. So, new armor 1, Bandos 0. Let's attack somebody else in the armor and see what happens. I think this guy is the exact same setup as I do. I was pulling out the Sith. Okay. The Scythe. One of the two. Wow. Well, we're one. Okay, well, we're winning this fight greatly. Oh, it looks like there's a special attack on there. I'll have to test that out too. You seem very tanky with this armor. I know that it's Torag, so it makes it seem tanky, but we're not really getting hit. And he's pulling out the claws. I didn't feel like eating. Let's go ahead and test out the new Scythe. So the first thing is that it's a one-handed weapon, so we can't use the new Defender with it. It is a 118 melee strength bonus and 128 slash bonus on this, so a bit less than the rapier, but we'll see. It does not have a special attack. I thought it did from the last fight, but let's see if we can just get some hits with this. Wow, okay, well, this guy's already using the, okay, thank God he took it off. Man, the attack animation actually looks like a special attack. That's why I was so confused, because it has that ring that goes around it. I'm not even praying. Did I pot up? Yeah, I did. Okay. I don't think the hits are going to be that exciting this fight. I just want you guys to take a look at, you know, the attack animation, what it looks like, and maybe we can get a hit or two. It would be nice to try this out, actually, against, like, even rune armor, but nobody here is going to be wearing it. Oh, there we go. There's a 24-hour first hit, I think. Wow, there we go. Back to back. Again, this isn't really in-depth testing of it. Wow. All right, I just actually went to a different screen. We killed him. Nice. Wasn't too bad. Here's what we have to test out the new staff. Again, don't know if it's the best thing, but 171 magic attack bonus off of this setup. There's no auto cast, unfortunately, with the staff, so we can't auto cast ancients, but we're still gonna go test out and hopefully get some nice hits on people. I ideally want to start attacking somebody in the new armor because it'll be free hits and he can't attack me. Look at this guy rushing. What is he doing? All right, we're going to attack somebody in melee. 175 right there. Okay, 32 barrage off the bat. 186. 35 barrage. No, come on, man. No one's going to kill. So I just want to see what kind of hits I can get off this. There's a 32. Wow, it's actually hitting quite consistently. 33. There's another one. Wow. 32. Oh my gosh. New staff coming in. Again, obviously, the magic bonus is pretty nutty with this setup, but still pretty consistent. We've only hit 3 or 4 zeros. Not bad. Not bad at all. Wow, that was very consistent. Good fight, my man. I think I've attacked that guy already. Not bad at all. Again, the tests here are obviously very inconclusive on anything. I just like testing these out, seeing what kind of hits you can get, and then seeing their animations and everything, but that wasn't too bad. Here are the new Vambraces. So plus 14 range attack bonus, plus 12 magic defense bonus, plus 2 range strength bonus. Straight up, full range tank. Here we go. Plus 232 range attack bonus. Plus 165 range defense, 169 magic, plus 9 range strength, plus 6 per bonus. Again, with this setup, it's not really the best thing ever, but just going to test it out, see if we can get any nice hits. I should probably get a range potion. And we'll use the new Dragonstone Dragon Bolts just to see what kind of hits we can get. Let's attack Alpha Peak Air and see what we hit. Okay, 29 to start off. Oh, he's praying range. My man. I'm just going to attack somebody else using the new Vambraces, pretty much with the same setup as us. He has the Serp Helm, but just to see what we can hit. 31, wow. I didn't really check to see what the max hit would be. 28. Okay, no chance. I'm going to attack a guy in Ancestral again, see if we can get a hit on. So far, nothing. Come on. Looking for a big hit. Oh, we're not potted up. That might help. I'm never going to hit on that armor. I'm never hitting on this. No chance. So that was just a bit of testing of the new potential raids to rewards. Again, if you guys want to try it out for yourself, which I'd highly recommend, this was just me doing a quick summary of each of the new items. Make sure to try out the new tournament worlds and test it out for yourself. You can not only do PvP, but also PvM, as I mentioned earlier. Thank you guys all for watching this video. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to drop a like and a comment, and I will see you next time for the next video, hopefully in a couple days. Bye-bye. Wow.